Good evening, and thanks for coming out to our first public forum for the joint land use study project that we have kicked off here in Wichita Falls and at Sheppard Air Force Base. We're happy to have everybody here with us tonight. I'm Glenn Barham, Mayor of Wichita Falls. We have several other folks here that are representing various communities throughout Wichita County and surrounding areas. But first, I'd like to make a few comments about what we're doing with this study. The study has been undertaken as a cooperative planning initiative between Sheppard Air Force Base and its auxiliary airfield in Frederick, Oklahoma, the City of Wichita Falls, and the surrounding regional communities. The idea of conducting the JLUS study was initiated in 2008 by the Sheppard Military Affairs Committee, and they'll be referred to as SMAC the rest of the night. That's a bunch of words to say, so we'll just say SMAC. And subsequently, the mayor of Wichita Falls, Iowa Park, Burke Burnett, and Cashin supported the concept of the study and pursuing the funds necessary to conduct the study. The United States Air Force nominated Sheppard for the JLUS to the Department of Defense Office of Economic Adjustment in June 2011, and we were subsequently approved to proceed with the study, with the local community acting as the host for the study. The planning grant was approved, and the study actually began in July of 2012. The participants in the JLUS include Wichita Falls, Wichita County, Burke Burnett, Cashin, Electra, Iowa Park, Pleasant Valley, Frederick, Oklahoma, and Tillman County in Oklahoma, Nortex Regional Planning Commission, Encore, and SMAC, along with Sheppard Air Force Base leadership. Ex officio members participating in the study will be Senator John Cornyn, Senator Ted Cruz, Representative Mac Thornberry, Senator Coburn from Oklahoma, Senator Inhofe in Oklahoma, Representative Cole in Oklahoma, and then Texas Senator Craig Estes and our Representative James Frank, as well as Oklahoma Senator Don Barrington and Oklahoma Representative Don Armies. Or is that Arms? Arms? Okay. I'll try to remember that. Matrix Design Group was the group selected from a competitive process to be our consultants on this project. Their leadership includes Mike Rapla, Bren Cox, the lead planner, Rick Rust, the project associate, Sal Notajomian? Jumian, okay. He is a project associate. The policy committee members include myself as the chair, Kay Yeager, who's the chairperson of SMAC, Colonel retired Tom Whalen, who is the president and CEO of SMAC, Linda Belchev is the secretary for SMAC, Brigadier General Michael Fantini, the commander of the 82nd Training Wing at Sheppard, Colonel Om Prakash, vice commander of the 82nd Training Wing, is the alternate, Colonel Dieter Barreis, commander of the 80th Flight Training Wing at Sheppard. Colonel Jamie Schofield is the vice commander of the 80th Training Wing. Carl Law, the mayor of Burke Burnett. Robin Murphy, the mayor of Cashin. Edwin Smith, council member, city of Cashin. Jim Smith, council member, city of Frederick. Dan Fears, the mayor of Iowa Park. The Honorable Woody Gossam, county judge for Wichita County. And Pat Norris, Commissioner for Precinct 2 in Wichita County.
On behalf of Matrix Design Group, we're excited to be a partner with all the communities here in Sheppard Air Force Base to address a joint land use study to look at sustaining the military operations at Sheppard as well as the economic development of the communities in the surrounding area. Next slide. We're going to cover some topics today, give you a background on what the joint land use study is. We're going to give you some insight into the things that we are going to be looking at and investigating. And then we're going to go through an exercise to get your input that we can use in developing compatible issues, discovery, and as we move forward in developing a toolbox for the communities. The objective here for you as the public is to gain an understanding of the process and the kind of products that are going to come out in the end, as well as helping us identify those issues. This week we've been working with the different jurisdictions and agencies to identify issues from their perspective. Kevin is the project manager representing the sponsor and who's our point of contact in working with the different communities. This is our consulting team. As I mentioned, I'm the project manager. My deputy is Celeste Warner. We have three people here this week working through our discovery process, but we're backed up by a number of people in our company and experts to provide the product and services that we intend to work with the communities. So we have a very experienced team. The other aspect, and one of the reasons I think we were selected by the community, is we've done over 20 of these joint land use studies across the United States, both for all the services in different rural communities and urban communities. And so we bring a vast experience of lessons learned and other tools. And we're going to sit down and look at the unique aspects of the challenges that you have here in Wichita Falls and the surrounding area with Sheppard Air Force Base, and then work together in a collaborative method to come up with an implementation plan to move forward. Okay, what is it? It's a federally funded program. It's a mechanism by which the Department of Defense reaches out to communities to help the communities assist them in dealing with military installations. Part of what the Office of Economic Adjustment does is deals with installations that have been closed. They also deal with installations that have realignment, and they also have a segment that deals with sustaining missions at active duty bases. And that's where the JLUS program falls under. So it's an attempt by the Department of Defense to assist communities to ensure the ability for the missions to be sustained at those active duty bases and provide a mechanism for compatible development for the communities. There are several objectives here. The key is that for the community, we look at the military, and you can kind of understand the military mission. Well, we're trying to protect the lives of the airmen and the aviators and provide the mechanism for them to train. But this process is a community-driven process. That's why the sponsor is the City of Wichita Falls, why the majority of the members are the communities and agencies, and the ex officios are the base. This is a community-driven process to look at that. And one of the major factors is that in this process, we're looking at the safety, welfare, and quality of life of the citizens, as well as the economic development in the communities in a collaborative effort of the ability to sustain the military operations. And again, also look at the ability to provide the capability for either increased missions or future missions into the future. It's very important that we talk about this as a collaborative process. It's not only going to be a collaborative process, it's an iterative process. It's very important that we ensure that we get all inputs. So that's why you see a very inclusive a number of jurisdictions that come into play, and why the public is an integral part, and that's why your presence here is key to the process. We're gonna try to focus on developing a set of implementation recommendations that are just not good ideas, but they're good ideas that make sense here in the communities related to Sheppard Air Force Base. And so we can only do that by a collaborative effort with the jurisdictions and the political leadership, as well as the technical leadership, to be able to tailor those down to things that are reasonably acceptable and can be implemented within the communities. We need to build consensus among the stakeholders, and the public is one of those stakeholders. And there will be a series of meetings as we go through for you to have ability to understand what we're doing within the committees and also to elicit your comments and inputs into the process. And then the bottom line is, I try to emphasize again, it's responsive to the local needs in the local communities. This kind of gives you an idea of what the responsibilities are. The policy committee that the mayor is in charge of is to shape and guide the direction of our study. It's trying to keep us within the lanes of the doable or the achievable, not just good ideas. And the technical committee is basically the workhorses that we work with to develop the understanding of the issues, to understand the different characteristics that we have to bring into play, and help us formulate the different tools and strategies that we will recommend in the process. Here's the approach. We're going to be looking at compatibility factors in the second or third part of this presentation. Celeste Warner will lead you through that, so you have a general understanding of that process. You have that in the fact sheet there, in a written document that we're going to work from, to understand that we're just not looking at a few items like land use or height, but we're looking at about 23 different factors to see if those have any impact, both either on the community or on the military operations. The goal is to develop an implementation strategy for preventing or mitigating the existing scenario. And why those two words are important is mitigation deals with an existing condition, and prevention is our ability to look forward into the future and provide mechanisms to ensure that incompatible development or incompatible issues do not occur. It's like buying an insurance. And through this process, we're going to determine, both from a technical perspective and from a political perspective, how much insurance the community wants to accept in their ability to protect the military mission and sustain the type of operations that are being conducted at Sheppard Air Force Base. What are we doing? Well, right now we're in the process of data collection. We're here this week on the second bullet, the Tiger Team visit. We're out here doing interviews. We're gathering additional data. We're having an opportunity to tour the base and meet with many of the different functions within the installation. We have a series of questions, and we're trying to fill in the data holes and the gaps so we have a comprehensive understanding, because what we want to be able to do is create this cloud of military operations that goes outside the boundaries of the installation that influence the land use as well as the citizens in the different communities. So that's a very important aspect. At the same time, we're also going to be looking at the kind of tools and processes that the community already has in trying to address these issues and concerns, and see where they can be strengthened, where they might need to have additive components to it, or create new tools that do not exist today. And then our objective is to really focus where these concerns are based on geography, very specifically where those issues occur, and so that if we promulgate or recommend some policy, that it's not a citywide or countywide policy if it's only affecting a small portion of the city or the county. So we really wanted to do that, and we want to time specifically to the issues that might be there. If it's a safety issue dealing with the clear zones and the accident potential zones around the airfield, that's only where we want to focus that attention in those types of tools. So it's very important for everybody to understand that this is really an effort to really fine-tune and hone down any of the recommendations so that we can have a reasonable approach to addressing any compatibility issues and concerns for both the community as well as the military. As we work through that process, we'll be working again with the different jurisdictions. We'll be trying to develop strategies and tools that are politically acceptable in the process in terms of recommendation. We're going to develop a draft report, and at the point that that draft report comes out, there'll be an opportunity for a public review comment period. around 30 to 45 days. And in that process, that document will be out on the website. It will be available in other venues for the public to access and review. We will conduct a public meeting at that time to address people's concerns that are included in that document. So as a member of the public, you'll have several opportunities to look at that document and process, provide comment both to us directly during the public workshop, electronically through the website, and hard copy if you so desire. And the last opportunity is you have elected officials, and that's another opportunity to express your comments to them in working through this process. Public involvement is important, and to give you an idea, we're just not looking at it in from one dimension. You're here as one of the public meetings. That's one mechanism that we go and look out and reach out to the public for their input and to answer questions and provide information to them. We also have informational brochures, and these will be, as you have one in front of you today, they'll also be on our website, and they'll be downloadable and you can print them out. And as we, just like this presentation tonight, after we're completed, within a week it will be up on the website for you to access and have other people to see the same type of information you've seen tonight. The document will also be up there, and as I mentioned, there'll be a specific public review period for that document, and we also have social networking, other mechanisms to be able to communicate back and forth and have you be able to provide your input. Next slide. Okay, how was the public forum addressed? The city and sponsors have done a very extensive effort to get the words out, and we have a very robust group here representing the communities, and we will continue to use this mechanism to communicate the next public forum and workshop. We also, as we are able to scope in where the issues are, there could be a very targeted mechanism to reach out to those landowners and stakeholders so that they understand what there's a concern and elicit their participation in the process at that point. We have a aggressive time schedule to be able to complete this. As I mentioned, you'll see on this chart here, this is a notional schedule. We have a detailed one that we're working to. But as I mentioned, is about two-thirds of the way through is when we're going to start seeing the draft document and the review process from the draft through the final document, and then it being presented to the different jurisdictions for acceptance. We started off with a very large study area. As it was mentioned before, not only were we looking at Sheppard Air Force Base, but we're looking at an auxiliary field in Oklahoma that is a key component to be able to support the military flying mission that is at Sheppard Air Force Base. As you see, there are a number of communities that are involved, and one of the reasons, as I mentioned, is military cloud of influence that we're trying to capture exists throughout there, because every time you see an aircraft flying overhead is in an approach to the airfield, that is a component in that we're trying to analyze. As you get closer to the airfields, whether they're in Oklahoma or in Texas, there are more and more issues that we have to look at and be concerned at. And so in the process, as you look at the map that's on your table, you'll see a green area around the airfield and in the communities. That's kind of reflective of the vertical height concerns related to the federal aviation rules associated with the municipal airport and the military airport. And so that gives you an idea of, for that one consideration, kind of the extent that we need to look at to see if there are potential issues. So that kind of gives you the overview of how we started, where we're going, what we're going to do over the next several months, how you're going to have an opportunity to be a partner in the development of this study, and then George Woodward's going to come up and give you an overview of the military installation so that you have a little bit better understanding of what happens there and kind of related to what I'm discussing is if we try to characterize that military operation, as well as the economic impact to the community that the Sheppard Air Force Base has. And after he's finished with his opportunity to present that information, Celeste Warner will get up and she will take you through the compatibility issue exercise in trying to get your input and feedback along those lines.